Namaste Narasimhaya.
Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Peshtaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhakti Vedanta Swamitriti Namine Namaste Saraswate Devi Kauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Desha Tarine Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadara Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna. So for the upcoming Shri Narasimha Chaturdashi, we thought why not discuss a little bit of Narasimha Lila. So in Srimad Bhagavata Purana and Shri Narasimha Purana, we get a lot of elaborate details about Shri Narasimha Lila. In Narasimha Purana, there is a pranama mantra in 3 verses called Shri Narasimha Pranama. Namaste Narasimhaya Prahlada Ladadayine Hiranyakashi Purvakshaha Shilatankana Kalaye. Namaste Narasimhaya Namaste. So namaha, nama means to take shelter of, to surrender, to pay the obeisances to offer one's respects to. So who are we offering the respects and who are we taking the shelter of? Namaste Narasimhaya. Nara means human, simha means lion. Narasimhaya. So why did the Lord take this most wonderful, unimaginable, never ever seen before form of Narasimha? So it is described in Bhagavata Purana. So here you can see Srimad Bhagavatam Canto 7. So in the end of Canto 6, in the conversation between Shukadeva Goswami and Maharaja Parikshit, Shukadeva Goswami tells Maharaja Parikshit that, hey Parikshit, that the Supreme Lord took the side of the demigods and with the intention of protecting Lord Indra, he came in the boar form and killed Hiranyaksha, and the same Supreme Lord came in the form of Narasimha and killed Hiranyakashipu. This is how Canto 6 of Srimad Bhagavatam ends. And in the beginning of Canto 7, let me read the verse for you. Shri Raja Uvacha. So who is the Raja Uvacha? Who is the Raja who is speaking? Raja Parikshit, Parikshit Maharaj. And what is he telling Shukadeva Goswami? Sama Priya Suhrut Brahman Bhutana Bhagavan Swayam Indrasyate Katam Daityan Avadir Vishamoyata. So Maharaja Parikshit is telling Shukadeva Goswami, the Lord Bhagavan is supposed to be 3 things. What is it? Samaha, he is supposed to be equal to everyone. Priyaha, he is supposed to love everyone. Suhrut, he is supposed to be the friend of everyone. Brahman, so when he says Brahman, he is referring to Shukadeva Goswami. Sama, Priya, Suhrut, Brahman, Bhutanam, Bhagavan, Swayam. The Lord is supposed to be equal to everyone, supposed to love everyone, supposed to be the friend of everyone. But, Indrasyate, but with respect to Indra, with the intention of protecting Indra, Indrasyate Katam Daityan. With the intention of protecting Indra, what did he do? Daityan Avadir Vishamoyata. It seems like as though the Lord is partial, Vishama, he has in his heart. Although Parikshit is actually a Bhagavata Priya, he's been hearing Bhagavata Purana, all the Krishna Leela, the Katha of Krishna right from his childhood. So actually Maharaja Parikshit does not have such question. But for the benefit of people in the future who may have such questions, who question, oh, why am I having so difficulty, but my neighbor seems to be very happy. I am such a good person, but he is an evil person, but seems like all good things are happening to him and all bad things are happening to him. So why does the Lord seem to be partial? So many people may ask in the future. So for the benefit of such people, Raja Parikshit is asking Shukadeva Goswami, can you please explain this to me? How come the Lord seems to be partial, although he is not supposed to be? So in answer to that, Shukadeva Goswami tells Maharaja Parikshit, Shri Rishir Uvacha, Sadhu Prishtam Maharaja, Haresh Charitam Adbhutam, Yad Bhagavata Mahatmyam, Bhagavad Bhakti Vardhanam. So Shukadeva Goswami is telling Maharaja Parikshit, Hey Parikshit, I express my appreciation and gratitude towards you for asking such a great question. Why is it such a nice question? Because Haresh Charitam Adbhutam. In answer to your question, a great, a wonderful Adbhuta Charita of Hari is about to be spoken. So thank you for giving that opportunity. That is why you have asked such a wonderful question. Yet Bhagavata Mahatmyam Bhagavad Bhakti Vardhanam, and listening to that pastime, Bhagavad Bhakti Vardhanam, the devotee's devotion towards the Lord will increase. And in answering Maharaja Parikshit's question, Shukadeva Goswami actually takes us into the Rajasuya Yajna of Maharaja Yudhishthir, who is the grandfather of Maharaja Parikshit. So once upon a time, when Maharaja Yudhishthir was performing Rajasuya Yajna, there was not a single rishi who did not attend that Rajasuya Yajna. There was not a single king across the world, and even the demigods were present, including Lord Indra. In fact, such was the grandeur and opulence of Indraprastha built by the Pandavas by the mercy of Lord Krishna, that when Lord Indra was approaching and entering Indraprastha, he asked, my goodness, what kind of a city is this? It seems to be even more beautiful than Amaravati. And somebody told Lord Indra, this is not the city, this is just a canopy built for the Rajasuya Yajna. So you can imagine, if a canopy in Rajasuya, built for Rajasuya Yajna and Indraprastha, is so opulent, how could be the actual opulence of the entire Indraprastha? So while the good-hearted people were very happy for the Pandavas, the evil-hearted people like Duryodhana, Karna, Shakuni, Shishupala were so envious and critical. And especially Shishupala, who happened to be the maternal cousin of Lord Krishna, every single opportunity he got, he would criticize Krishna. In fact, even when he learned to speak while he was just babbling the broken words, even from that time Shishupala was criticizing Krishna. And in this August assembly in Rajasuya Yajna, filled with all kinds of saints and kings and all the demigods and everybody else present, Shishupala criticized Krishna one after another. Krishna patiently kept count of it, and at the count of 100, he released his Sudarshana Chakra and chopped off Shishupala's head. Although that was wonderful, what was more wonderful was when Shishupala, the Chedi Raja's neck was cut off, everybody in this August assembly of audience saw that the soul of Shishupala immersed and became one in the body of Krishna. Having witnessed such a wonderful thing, Maharaja Yudhishthir asked Sage Narada, the great Sage Narada, that how come? That we witness such a wonderful event. Where in which Shastra, Sage Narada, is it given that by criticizing the Supreme Lord, one will attain mukti, sayujya mukti? Where is it given? And if that is the case, how about Vena? Vena was another very evil king in the past historic times. But Vena, although he was also very critical of Krishna, he did not attain mukti. Instead, he was punished in the hell. So Yudhishthir was completely bewildered, his mind was disturbed, his intelligence was wavered like a lamb kept under the wind. So he asked Sage Narada, could you please clarify this for me? And in answering this question, Narada Muni, as he was describing, he narrates this wonderful pastime of Narasimha Lila. And when you go through Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 7, you will see that as much as it is about Narasimha Lila, it is equally about the glories of his great devotee Prahlada. So for the next few minutes, we will try not only to understand the glories of Narasimha Lila, but also the greatness of his loving, exalted, exemplary devotee, Shri Prahlada Maharaj. So, Namaste Narasimhaya. And when did Narasimha Lila happen? Although it is accounted in Bhagavatam Canto 7, the actual appearance of Lord Narasimha happened in the 6th Manvantara. There are 14 Manvantaras in one day, 12 hours of Lord Brahma, the creator of the universe. And in 6th Manvantara, between the end of Satya Yuga and the beginning of Treta Yuga, in that Kala is when Narasimha Lila happened, just before the Samudra Manthana Lila. So, Namaste Narasimhaya. So, I take shelter of this most wonderful, divine, beautiful form of Sri Narasimha. And why did Narasimha come in this wonderful half-man, half-lion form, which nobody had never seen before? So, as Krishna says in Srimad Bhagavad Gita, Paritranaya Sadhunam Vinashaya Cha Dushkrutam, to protect Paritranaya Sadhunam, to protect the devotees, and Vinashaya Cha Dushkrutam, Krita means evil, Krita means action, Dushkrita means evil action. So, Vinashaya Cha Dushkrutam, to destroy the evil people and to protect his devotees, those are the two businesses that the Lord takes care of in every incarnation of his, and that is no different in Narasimha Lila as well. So who is this sadhu, who is this devotee that Lord Narasimha came to protect? Paritranaya Sadhunam. So coming back to the Narasimha Pranama, Namaste Narasimhaya Prahlada Lada Daine. So Narasimha comes daine to give ahlada, joy to Prahlada, who is always perfectly happy. Prahlada lada daine. And what wonderful 5-year-old boy this boy is. He is such a great devotee that history has recorded his name. Everybody takes his name as the measure of standard to judge somebody else's amount of good qualities they have. If you have to know how good somebody is, how many good qualities they have, Prahlada Maharaj is the measuring standard for that. And this boy is so glorious, such an exemplary devotee, that when Hiranyakashipu was going here and there and harassing everybody, all the devatas went to Lord Vishnu and humbly submitted the prayers, "Oh my dear Lord, please appear and save us. If not for you, who can protect us?" And at that time, let me go back to Bhagavatam, Canto 7, Chapter 4. So, Supreme Lord Vishnu assures the devatas that no doubt I will definitely come. I already know how harassed you are, how tortured you are. I will definitely come and relieve your pain. Wait for the opportune time. And when the devatas asked, when is that opportune time? When exactly will you come, my lord? The Lord says, Yada deveshu vedeshu goshu vipreshu thagushu dharme maicha vidveshaha sava ashu vinashyati. Anybody, yada, whoever, whenever, when, deveshu, who is an enemy of the demigods, vedeshu, an enemy of Vedic literatures, goshu, enemy of cows, vipreshu, enemy of brahmanas, sadhushu, enemy of the devotees of the Lord, dharme, enemy of the religious principles, mai, an enemy of the Supreme Lord himself, his destruction is guaranteed. And when exactly will Lord appear? In the very next verse, verse number 28 of chapter 4, canto 7, Lord himself says, Nirvairaya prashantaya swasutaya mahatmane prahradaya yadadrunye danishyepi varorjitam. The Lord Himself, in front of all the demigods, is glorifying His devotee Prahlada Maharaj using three adjectives. Nirvairaya, he who has no enemies. He has absolutely no hatred towards anybody, no envy towards anybody. He has no enemies whosoever. Prashantaya, no matter what, he is always calm and peaceful. And later we will see that his own father, what to speak of others, was trying to kill him in so many different ways. But Prahlada Maharaj was Prashantaya, always peaceful no matter what. Swasutaya Mahatmane, who is a Mahatma? These days we call anybody and everybody Mahatma. But to really identify and know the meaning of Mahatma, we should refer to the pages of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. One who has taken the shelter of Dhaivi Prakriti, one who has taken the shelter of the Supreme Lord, he is a Mahatma. So Prahlada Maharaj fits the bill. He is a Mahatma. He has completely taken the shelter of Sri Narasimha Dev. So he is Nirvairaya, Prashantaya, and he is a Mahatma. So the Lord says, when Prahlada Maharaj, who has all these exemplary qualities, is harassed by Swasutaya, his own father, at that time I will appear. And immediately, if you see, continue this chapter, Narad Muni, who happens to be the spiritual master of this great devotee Prahlada Maharaj, starts glorifying his devotee, his disciple. Perhaps nowhere else in history you will see a spiritual master so publicly glorifying his own disciple. We only hear and read of the cases where the disciples are glorifying the spiritual master. But here, what a change, that Narad Muni, the spiritual master, is glorifying his disciple. And where is he glorifying him? In the Rajasuya Sabha, filled with such great saints, demigods and all the kings. In that Sabha he is glorifying Prahlada Maharaj. And how is he doing it? He says, Brahmanya Shila Sampannaha Satya Sando Jitendriyaha Atmavat Sarva Bhutanam Ekapriya Supruttamaha. Some of the qualities of Prahlada Maharaj are being brought out by his spiritual master Narad Muni. Brahmanyaha. Who is a Brahmana? Brahmana, not somebody who just wears a thread and Brahmana in name only. One who lives his whole life, everything as per the scriptures, he is Brahmanyaha. Prahlada Maharaj is Brahmanyaha. Shila Sampannaha, he is a treasure house of all the wonderful qualities. Satya Sando, he is always a seeker of absolute truth. Jitendriya, Prahlada Maharaj was a tender 5-year-old boy, but he has already established complete control over his senses. Jitendriya, Atmavat Sarvabhutanam. Anybody who is a devotee of the Lord starts displaying the qualities of the Lord. And one of those qualities of the Supreme Lord is that he sees everybody equally without any discrimination. And likewise, Prahlada Maharaj also, Atmavat Sarva Bhutanam, he saw everybody equally without any kind of discrimination. Ekapriya Sukruttamaha, he was the best friend of everyone. He had no enemies. Continuing, Sri Narad Muni brings out the qualities of Prahlada Maharaj. Dasavat Sannattaryangri Pitruvat Deenavatsalaha Bratruvat Sadrishesnigdo Gurushva Ishwara Bhavanaha Vidyata Rupa Janmadyo Manastamba Vivarjitaha. Dasavat Sannattaryangri Pitruvat Deenavatsalaha Bratruvat Sadrishesnigdo. Entire human relation principles boil down in three lines of this shloka. Dasavat. So Prahlada Maharaj acted exactly like a menial servant, rendering all kinds of services and giving the utmost respect to who? Sannattaryangrihi, those who are superior to him. And who do we think are superiors to us? Those who are superior in age, those who are superior in position, those who are superior in knowledge, and those who are superior in ashrama. And any kind of superiors, any of these four, Prahlada Maharaj, Dasavart, rendered all kinds of services to them and gave them the utmost respect. Pitruvat Dinavat Salaha, what about juniors, those who are beneath him? Dinavat, for them he would teach them Vatsalaha, just like his children, just like a father would treat his children by showering love and affection. So to the seniors, upward went respect, to the juniors, downward came love and affection. What about the equals? Pratruvat Sadrushe Snigdo. To all his equals, he spread brotherhood and friendship. Ideal. He knew exactly how to deal with everybody. Gurush Ishwara Bhavanaha. Anybody who were his spiritual master, he gave them as much respect as the Supreme Lord himself. Ishwara Bhavanaha. Vidyat Rupa Janmatyo Manastamba Vivarjitaha. In this world, pride comes because primarily of four things. Vidyanta, perhaps because of somebody's knowledge. Rupa, because of beauty. Janma, because of taking birth in a certain family. And Aishwarya, Shri. The same thing even Kunti Maharani utters in her prayers to Krishna. So these four things is the cause of pride for somebody. And the interesting twist about pride is, the pride that comes from something good destroys that very same good thing. It's like a termite. It comes from the wood and eats up the wood. So it's very, very dangerous, and one has to be extremely beware and cautious of it. And look at this wonderful boy, 5-year-old boy. He had so much vidya, so much of knowledge, that he was even better. He surpassed his teacher Shanda and Amarka when he was sent to the Gurukul by his father. He had understood the essence of Vedas. He was performing devotional service. Rupa, he was so adorable, so loving, so handsome, so cute. Janma, he took birth in a family of asuras. Although he took birth in the family of asuras, what kind of asura? His father was practically ruling not just this planet but all the 14 planetary systems. He had defeated even the demigods. He was his father, Hiranyakashipu. Janma, Aishwarya, there was no dearth of wealth for Prahlada Maharaj. But in spite of having Vidya, Rupa, Janma, Aishwarya, what is the greatness about Prahlada Maharaj? Manastamba Vivarjitaha. He had given up all kind of pride that comes from this. So I will not go into all the details of all the verses, but this continues, and Narad Muni glorifies Prahlada Maharaj like anything in Rajasuya Sabha. So such is the glory of Prahlada Maharaj that even today, not only humans but demigods even take Prahlada Maharaj's name as the standard for being an epitome of all good qualities. And to protect that sadhu, that devotee, Prahlada Lada Daine, who appeared, Lord Narasimha, in this most wonderful half-man, half-lion form. So dear devotees, today we have discussed the first two lines of Sri Narasimha Pramana, Pranama, Namaste Narasimhaya Prahlada Lada Daine. We've understood in what context in Canto 7 this Narasimha Leela is being narrated by Narada Muni to Yudhishthir Maharaj in Rajasuya Sabha and by Shukadeva Goswami to Parikshit Maharaj. And at the top level, by Shuddha Goswami to all the saints in Naimisharanya. We've understood very slight, we've gotten a glimpse of the glorious qualities of Prahlada Maharaj. Next, in session 2, we will see the demoniac qualities of this great villain called Hiranyakashipu. So Paritranaya Sadhunam, the sadhu who was supposed to be protected was Prahlada Maharaj. Who is this Dushkruta whose Vinasha is about to happen? That is Hiranyakashipu, and we will know more about this in the next session. So thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Namaste, Namaste.